So now,
finally, in Worcester, Massachusetts,
Worcestershire, Massachusetts,
WCW Nitro, and Mean Gene's in the ring, baby. Mean Gene calls out Goldberg, Wolfpack music plays, and here comes David Flair and Tori Wilson. This son of a bitch. I don't know how Ric Flair's not crying right now.
He's about to do it.
Ric Flair, David Flair and Tori are in the ring, so they're going to wait for Ric Flair to come out here. And this acting is horrible. They are so lost. And here comes Goldberg looking like a fucking brick shithouse. This guy's gigantic. And he's got the nice pants on. He's got no shirt on, though. He's looking real hairy, liking it. And then it goes to commercial as Goldberg's making his entrance. What the fuck? And then Goldberg comes out again, finally. Goldberg says, I got a lot of respect for your family, so I'm not going to kill you.
Dude, okay.
That's a good line.
Okay, dude. Like, Goldberg interrupts him. You're right. He does look like an absolute monster. His traps are crazy.
Crazy,
bro. But then he cuts a promo. He's 170-something wins in on this streak. And he comes to the ring and he cuts a promo about the business. He goes, Ric Flair has done it all, kid. Like, that yes. David's not this motherfucker's son. He goes, he's done a lot in this business. What the fuck does Goldberg care about this business?
Listen, man, he put over the big man already by now.
This is crazy, man. Absolute insanity. I was like, I can't believe he's cutting a this business promo. This is crazy.
This business that I love.
Not do anything for your father because he's done a lot for this business that I'm in and that I love.
So David Flair starts poking at Goldberg's chest and he's giving him the business and Goldberg grips him up. This run-in, it has to be an all-timer for me.
Yeah.
Because Ric Flair, House of fucking Fire, charges out, whips his jacket off, gets into the ring.
He's by the way, from backstage, like from backstage, NXT arena, and they tell him, hey, Flair, look what's going on in the ring. And he's like, what? And he runs to the ring.
He wasn't even paying attention.
He runs.
Who's that kid?
Tony Schiavone said, look, Flair's streaking to the ring.
So Flair gets in the ring, fired up, his son's gripped up by Goldberg, and what does Flair do to stop this monster? He grabs him by the shoulder, he whips him around, and he chops him.
Hell yeah.
He chops him one time, and then turns his attention to David, who's already ran away. I could not stop fucking laughing at the chop that Flair, like Goldberg even looks at him like, what the fuck?
Goldberg obviously doesn't respect the business.
And then fucking Flair's paying attention to David Flair, who's leaving. Goldberg's like, fuck this. He grips Flair up. just press slams him.
Is there a move more over than the Goldberg press slam?
Dude, it was all, and it looked great, too.
The main event, he does now, it again, and it's crazy.
Ric Flair is losing it now. He's screaming in Goldberg's face. Goldberg's like, you've lost your mind.
Buddy.
And he says, you've crossed the line, Flair. And Flair says, the line! The line! I am the line!
Pal.
And then he's flipping out. Flair just starts rolling on the floor. And then he books himself against Goldberg in the main event. Ric Flair rules.
Yeah, he does.
That's crazy. Ah, God, I loved it, dude. Like, the fucking chop, and then Goldberg's just like, fuck this, press slam.
Yeah, this You're is dead. Awesome.
God. So, yeah, Flair and Goldberg... in the main event, which I was pretty excited for.